नमस्कार। ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ अग्रवाल क्लासेस आई रचना अग्रवाल वेलकम यू ऑल इन टुडेज क्लास नेचर एंड सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ मैनेजमेंट। आज हम पढ़ेंगे बिजनेस मैनेजमेंट एंड द टॉपिक इज द फर्स्ट एपिसोड आई विल कंसिस्ट ऑफ डेफिनेशन एंड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट। व्हाट इज मैनेजमेंट? फर्स्ट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड मीनिंग एंड डेफिनेशंस ऑफ इट। Management is an individual or group of individuals, those who accept the responsibilities of an organization. They plan, organize, direct and control all essential activities of an organization. Management does not do the work themselves, but they motivate others to do the work and coordinate. They bring all together for achieving the objectives of the organization. Management is required in all points of organization. Management consists of interrelated functions that are performed by all the managers. Let us understand the concept of management through its a few definitions. According to Harold Kunsch, management is the art of getting things done through others and with formally organized groups. Mary Parker Foley has also said that management is the art of getting things done through people. According to F.W. Taylor, management is the art of knowing what you want to do and then seeing that they do it in the best and cheapest way. So my dear students, Mary Parker Follett ki definition bahut short and sweet hai, you can understand it very easily. Ki jo management hai wo ek art hai, kaam ko getting things done through others, kaam ko kisi aur ke through karwana. So it is an act of creating and maintaining such a business environment wherein the members of the organizations can work together and achieve business objectives effectively and efficiently. Management can be defined as a process of getting things done with the aim of achieving goals effectively and efficiently. The important terms that I have used in this definition is management is a process of getting things done with the aim of achieving goals effectively and efficiently. Let us understand these three terms in detail first. Process. What does the term process means? Business management jo hai wo ek process hota hai, because the primary functions or the activities that management performs to get things done, these functions are planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. So it is a process, kyunki group of activities hoti hai, step by step, one by one another next. Then comes effectively. Effectiveness is concerned with the end result. Effectiveness refers to the completion of work on time. Kaam ka samay pe pura hona. That is called effectiveness. It basically means finishing the given task. Effectiveness in management is concerned with doing the right task. Sahi kaam kare. Completing activities and achieving goals and targets in adequate time given. Proper time ke andar hame kaam karna hai. That is effectively. Then comes efficiently. Efficiently means doing the task correctly and with the minimum cost, optimum utilization of resources. Management is concerned with efficient use of input resources, which ultimately reduces cost. Aapki cost kam hai, profits higher hai. That is called efficiently. It is important for the management to achieve goals effectiveness with minimum resources as efficiency as possible while maintaining a balance between effectiveness and efficiency. Let us take an example. If the target of an employee is to produce 100 units of anything, let it be a blackboard, in 1 month, and achieving the target by wasting resources and mishandling the machinery, it will not be in favor of the organization. It will not be in the interest of the organization. On the other hand, efficiency to nahi hai. On the other hand, if the employee spends lot of time in handling the machine, wo apna jyada tar time machine ko carefully handle karne mein hi laga deta hai, uski technique ko samajhne mein hi laga deta hai. Resources को carefully manage करने में लगा जाता है, then he also fails to complete the target on time. So it will also not be in the favor or interest of the organizations. Manager sees to it that this target is achieved on time and with optimum use of resources. Optimum use of resources, जैसे मैंने आपको बताया, with the minimum wastage, minimum cost and higher profit. अगर हम resources की बात करते हैं, तो basically these are 5 M's. M for men, M for machine, M for material, M for money, and M is for method. These are called 5 M's. And this is possible when there are in proper direction, coordination and integration of the processes and activities to achieve the desired results. Now let us understand the characteristics of management. The first part that we have done is definitions, then we will do characteristics of management. Let us go for it. The first one is management. मैनेजमेंट के जो कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स हैं, उनमें जो फर्स्ट वन है दैट इज मैनेजमेंट इज परवेसिव. परवेसिव मींस इट इज प्रेजेंट और नोटिसेबल इन एवरी पार्ट. इट इज यूनिवर्सल. ऑल द ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस, वेदर इट इज प्रॉफिट मेकिंग और नॉन प्रॉफिट मेकिंग, दे रिक्वायर मैनेजमेंट फॉर मैनेजिंग देयर एक्टिविटीज. सो इट इज एन यूनिवर्सल इन नेचर. मैनेजमेंट इज अ यूनिवर्सल फिनोमेनन. The use of management is not restricted to business firms only. It is applicable in profit making, non-profit making, business, non-business organization, even in hospitals, schools, houses, everything has to be managed properly. Concept of management is acceptable in whole world, whether it is any of the country or any part of the country. Then comes the second one. The second one is goal-oriented. Her organization कोई ना कोई अपना प्री डिटरमाइंड ऑब्जेक्टिव या गोल लेके चलती है और मैनेजमेंट जो है उसको हेल्प करता है कि उन गोल्स को टाइमली अचीव कर सके, स्मूथली अचीव कर सके. एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैज अ सेट ऑफ बेसिक गोल्स व्हिच आर बेसिक रीजन फॉर इट्स एग्जिस्टेंस. मैनेजमेंट यूनाइट्स द एफर्ट्स ऑफ डिफरेंट इंडिविजुअल्स इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन टुवर्ड्स अचीविंग दिस गोल्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ अ कंपनी इज टू सेल 1000 यूनिट्स ऑफ लेट इट बी अ पेन, 1000 यूनिट जिसको सेल करना है, देन मैनेजर विल प्लान द कोर्स ऑफ एक्शन, मोटिवेट ऑल द एम्प्लॉइज एंड ऑर्गेनाइज ऑल रिसोर्सेज कीपिंग इन माइंड द मेन टारगेट ऑफ सेलिंग 1000 यूनिट्स ऑफ पेन. तो जो टारगेट ओरिएंटेड होता है ये गोल ओरिएंटेड होता है मैनेजमेंट. देन कम्स द नेक्स्ट प्रोसेस कंटीन्यूअस. यू नहीं कि एक बार सेल्स का टारगेट अचीव हो गया और मैनेजमेंट स्टॉप हो गया, या प्लानिंग कर लिया उसके बाद मैनेजमेंट स्टॉप हो गया. नो, it is an ongoing process which tends to persist as long as the organization exists. Jitna lamba jab tak organization exists karta hai tab tak ye process jo hai management ka chalta hai. It is required in every sphere of the organization, whether it is production, human resource, finance or marketing. The process of management is a series of continuous and separate functions: planning, organizing, directing, staffing and controlling. These functions are simultaneously performed by managers all the time. Har waqt kiye jaate hain simultaneously. That is why it is a continuous process. Then comes the next one, multidimensional. Management is not confined to the administration of people only. Sirf logo tak simit nahi, but it also manages work, process and operations, so which makes it a multidisciplinary activity. Management is a complex activity that has three main dimensions. The number one is management of work. All organization exists for the performance of some work. Management translate these works in terms of goals to be achieved. जो भी अपने goals हैं उनमें translate करता है और लोगों को assign the means to achieve it. लोगों को means वे देता है कि उस रास्ते चल के हमें उसको अचीव करना है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वर्क टू बी अकम्प्लिश्ड इन स्कूल इज व्हाट? प्रोवाइडिंग एजुकेशन. सो मैनेजमेंट मेक श्योर दैट वर्क इज अकम्प्लिश्ड इफिशियंटली एंड इफेक्टिवली. देन कम्स मैनेजमेंट ऑफ पीपल. ह्यूमन रिसोर्स द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एसेट ऑफ एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कैन विन ओवर कॉम्पिटिटर with efficient employees only, because two organizations can have same physical, technological, financial resources but not human resource. Management has to get that accomplished through people only. Management has two dimensions. It implies dealing with individual employees with diverse needs and behavior, and also with dealing group of people. Is that clear to you? Then comes management of as we have discussed, management of work, management of people, and the third one is management of operations. It refers to activity. production cycle such as buying input, converting them into semi-finished goods and then finished goods. Management of operations concentrate on mixing management of work with management of people, deciding what work has to be done. Kaun kya kaam karega? Kya kaam kiya jayega? Kis tarike se? How it has to be done? And who will do it? This is called management of operations. And all these three activities intuitively make it a multidimensional activity. In tino ki wajah se ye kehlata hai multidimensional activity. Then comes the next one is group activity. An organization consists of various members who have different needs, expectations and beliefs. Alag alag jagah se log join karte hain kisi bhi organizations ko with their different needs, different motives, different expectations. But once they join any organization, they become part of that and they have the same common objective and they work for achieving that same or common goal. So it requires supervision, teamwork and coordination, and in this way management comes into the picture. An organization is a collection of diverse individuals. Alag alag tarike ke log aate hain alag alag needs ke saath mein, and management should enable all its members to grow and develop as needs and opportunities changes. So this is a group activity. Then comes the next one, dynamic function. An organization exists in a business environment. Koi bhi organization jo hai wo business environment mein exist karta hai aur bahut sare factors hote hain, social, political, legal, technological, economic factors. To in sab mein agar thoda sa bhi change aa jata hai to organization ki growth and jo performance hai wo definitely affect hoti hai. तो इन सिचुएशंस को ओवरकम करने के लिए मैनेजमेंट को इस तरीके की स्ट्रेटजीज फॉर्मुलेट करनी चाहिए और इम्प्लीमेंट करनी चाहिए कि वो इस सिचुएशन में उनको अप्लाई कर सके. इसलिए मैनेजमेंट का जो फंक्शन होता है वो डायनामिक होता है. एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विल सर्वाइव एंड सक्सीड ओनली व्हेन इट इज डायनामिक. फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी होनी चाहिए. इट मस्ट कंटिन्यूअसली ब्रिंग इन न्यू एंड क्रिएटिव आइडियाज, इन न्यू प्रोडक्ट्स, इनोवेटिव प्रोडक्ट फीचर्स, new ads, new marketing techniques, etc. Then comes the next one is intangible foods. Management intangible ka matlab jisko hum dekh nahi sakte, jisko hum chu nahi sakte, but we can feel it. So management can neither be seen nor touched, but one can feel its existence in the way the organization functions. Organization ka kaam dekh karke hum usko mehsoos kar sakte hain. The success or failure of management can be judged only by its results. If there is good discipline, good productivity, good profits, etc., then the management is successful. And similarly, if discipline is bad, low production, low profits, then it leads to bad management. For example, if the inventory of the finished goods is increasing day by day, it clearly indicates mismanagement of marketing and sales department. So we cannot see it, but we can feel management. This is called intangible force. Then comes the next one, जो हमने शुरू में किया था, that management is the art of getting things done. So काम करवाना है. Managers का task होता है कि काम खुद नहीं करके अपनी team से वो काम करवाएं. They get the work done through workers and subordinates. तो क्या उनको slaves treat करें? No, the workers should not be treated like slaves. They should not be tricked. They should not be threatened. They should not be forced to do the work. But an environment should be created. A good, healthy work environment should be there so that subordinates and workers are working there happily. And a good atmosphere will be maintained. And work is done. So precisely I can say that all the activities, functions and the processes of the organizations are interconnected to one another, and it is the task of the management to bring them together in such a way that they help in reaching the intended result. So this was about the definitions and characteristics of management. I hope you will like it. Thank you.